I'm Fauzia. I'm a gender justice feminist. ਜਿਹਦਾ ਮਤਲਬ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਮੈਂ ਇਹੋ ਜਿਹੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੀ ਹਾਂ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਯਕਜਾਨ ਹੋਵਣ ਵਿਦਾਊਟ ਐਨੀ ਕਾਇੰਡ ਆਫ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਸ ਇਨ ਜੈਂਡਰ ਸੈਕਸ਼ੁਐਲਿਟੀ ਕ੍ਰੀਡ ਔਰ ਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਈ ਟੀਚ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਦਿਸ ਸਟੱਫ ਇਨ ਦ ਯੂਨਾਈਟਿਡ ਸਟੇਟਸ ਪਰ ਹੈ ਮੈਂ ਲਾਹੌਰ ਦੀ ਧੀ ਵਿਚ ਮੀਨਸ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਫਰੋਮ ਲਾਹੌਰ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਆਲਸੋ ਅ ਮਿਊਜ਼ੀਸ਼ੀਅਨ ਦਿਸ ਟਾਈਮ ਆਈ ਕੇਮ ਟੂ ਲਾਹੌਰ ਅ ਫਿਊ ਮੰਥਸ ਅਗੋ ਵੈਨ ਦ ਜ਼ੈਨਬ ਕੇਸ ਹੈਡ ਜਸਟ ਬਰੋਕਨ ਐਂਡ ਇਟ ਵਾਜ਼ ਐਕਸਟ੍ਰੀਮਲੀ ਡਿਸਟਰਬਿੰਗ to hear about what had happened to this poor young girl, how she had been raped and murdered. And it obviously caused a hue and cry amongst all kinds of sectors of society. And it affected me, especially as an artist, very deeply. Then main sochan lag payi ke what kind of society, right, can enable such things to happen, or if not enable, you know, create an atmosphere where people can do this sort of a thing. And of course, I realized it's all about patriarchy, you know, patriarchy mixed with often misinterpretations of religion, in which girl, children, women are seen as less than that, you know, less important than boys or as men. And when you dehumanize people, a whole gender like that, then of course you can behave with any kind of cruelty and it becomes acceptable. So I came to my old friend Faraz in Lahore, who owns a studio here called Infinity Music Works. Faraz is somebody I've known for a long time. We have collaborated in the past. And I knew that if there was one man with feminist inclinations in the music industry whom I could trust with my vision, and he might come up with something, that was Faraz. It was very interesting, you know, I just came in and I just had this very abstract concept. I said, I want to do something musically with you, Faraz, help me out. I have this small kind of a poem that I've written. I want you to listen to it and then do something, you know, work your magic with it. And I read out this small piece that I had written, you know, about the fears that all women from the minute that they are young girls, they have about how society is a very dangerous place for them and how they can be attacked at any minute, how vulnerable they are and how they wish to escape from that. And I read it out and he was sitting here and he just closed his eyes. He turned to his computer screen and I mean, within minutes, he had composed the beginnings of what I hope and I think and I believe has turned into an amazing musical track. And he also came up, you know, a day or two later, I came back as we were thinking and talking and he came up with this Punjabi jinnu mukhda kehnde ne, husn tere ne pagal kita, ishq da pyala, pita hi pita. Faraz came up with another very interesting suggestion because I was telling him, you know, I want to see something in the video part of this music which shows a connection between different types of human beings. So he suggested, well, let's call Nigat. We invited her, she came and she just said, that's it, I'm down with you on this project, because she too really believes in this concept of gender and social justice. So she said, I'm in. And it was amazing. When we shot the video, it was actually 23rd of March, which is Pakistan Day. And when we were shooting this video, which was right after she had been given her award, which is one of the highest awards an artist can get in Pakistan. For me, it was very important that we include somebody from the transgender community who has been working within the feminist movement of Pakistan. And so I reached out to Neeli Rana and she agreed. I mean, this was miraculous. She's a senior member of the transgender or what we call here the Khwaja Sara community. And I mean, she added a whole other dimension to our music video because, you know, when you look at it, you see these three women who are strong, independent women representing, you know, different parts of society, the professor and musician or singer, along with the dancer, along with the transgender woman of the feminist movement. And we have come together with our friend Faraz, who is supporting us in his music, right? And we are creating the vision for a new world where there will be no boundaries whatsoever of gender or sex or class or creed or male or female. You will see in the music video also a concept that actually was suggested by Faraz while we were discussing different facets of how this would take shape. At first, I was resistant because, you know, it's scary for a middle-aged woman to come in front of a camera without any kind of makeup, because makeup is what is a mask that we put on to, in a way, protect ourselves and to project a certain image. And he said, no. We want to create something that is really raw, that when people who view the video and hear the music, they can connect at that level that is not of intellect and not of a very made-up kind of a music video, but something that connects at the level of the heart, the gut, where we see each other the way we really are. And so in the video, none of the women you'll see, we appear completely without makeup, and that makes us really very vulnerable, you know? And that vulnerability connects us back to the story that I initially wanted to tell of a young girl who was so vulnerable and she was taken advantage of in this inhuman way. We are enjoying putting on makeup on each other, and we are laughing, and we are thinking of this whole thing, universe, in a way as a joke, not to be taken seriously, but taken also very seriously in order to change it so that it becomes pleasurable. It becomes a place jithe assi sare hass ga ke ikatthe reh sakde ne.